see everyone right now, and I can imagine my father-in-law being here. He would be so excited and probably hooting and hollering right now. But on behalf of my husband Troy and my family, I would like to thank everyone for taking the time to come out from your busy holiday and joining us in honoring the memory of Gordon Oliver. He was a friend to many of you, and he was family to me. If you knew my father-in-law, then you knew he always enjoyed having a good conversation. It really didn't matter what the topic was. He just wanted to engage and have us solve the pursuits of all the world's problems and solve them right then and there. When I first met Gordy, I realized I was in for a real joyride. He was full of fire and zest from our first dinner together, through my courtship with his son, the birth of our two children, Dalton and Chase, his frequent visits to our mountain retreat where he requested to have his ashes released into the waterfall. If you notice your prayer card, you'll see that waterfall on that picture. And then right up until the last moment that I saw him alive, he was so full of spunk and quick wit. He took me under his wing all those years ago and showed me the ways according to Gordy. And while you might think that sounds a bit sarcastic, it really isn't. My father-in-law was a country boy. He was proud of his upbringing, proud of his hard work, and most of all, he was proud of his family. He was also a person you could depend on to do the right thing when it came to helping others. He wasn't the one to talk about the kinds of things he did, like when he noticed his neighbor's motor broke down, he just went over and fixed it. Or like the little abandoned cemetery behind the apartment complex up there in Colesville. For 40 years, he took care of that, and he trained me, and he trained Troy to make sure that we showed it the respect it deserved. He didn't do this because he expected anything back. He did it because he felt it was the right thing to do. And that's how he lived his life. He treated others as honestly as he could. And it reminds me of a Bible verse, 1 John 3:18. You show love for others by truly helping them, not merely talking about it.